Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making mashed sweet potatoes. And this is the dish that I decided to make to go on your Easter table. Usually we think of mashed potatoes, and I thought we would do something a little different this time. You may quite often make candied sweet potatoes or sweet potatoes with marshmallows on the top. Or baked sweet potatoes, and you may have had them as sweet potato fries, but you don't usually hear of them as mashed sweet potatoes. So I thought we would put that with our ham that we're going to have and have an enjoyable Easter dinner. So I want to show you how I make my mashed sweet potatoes. Start with 4 tablespoons of butter that I've melted in a sizable pot. This has to be big enough to hold about 3 sweet potatoes, and you want to be able to boil this on the stove. Now to my butter, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of milk, and I'll just stir that together. Now I have some seasonings here. This is 1 teaspoon of sugar, and I have 1/2 teaspoon of salt. So we're going to put the seasoning in right in with our butter and milk. Now that does not seem like a lot of liquid. However, a lot of the liquid is going to be provided by the sweet potatoes. Right here I have 3 medium-sized red sweet potatoes that I have peeled, and I've cut them into chunks that are fairly equally sized. It's pretty important that you have them equal sized, because you're going to cook these on the stove and you're going to test for doneness, and they all need to be done at the same time. So if you have a very large piece right beside a very small piece, the small piece is going to get done first. So you try to make all the pieces about the same size. Now it will be impossible to do that perfectly, but once you get these in the pan with what you've mixed up, stir. Try to get everything coated nicely. And there's just enough liquid in there to do that. And that's about all. What I'm going to do is bring this over to the stove. And I'm going to turn it on over low to medium heat while I watch and stir. So I'm going to watch it heat up a little bit. And then my next step will be to put a lid that fits on it. Once it's going well, you can actually see some liquid there in the bottom, and I'll be seeing more liquid as I heat this and stir. But when it's going well, it's going to get capped with a lid that fits. And then it should cook about a half hour. It's going to take probably longer than your regular white potatoes. So I can hear them sizzling already. So it's my job to just stand here and stir for a little bit until they get going very well, and then they will do the rest of the work. Our sweet potatoes are done, and they cooked for about 25 minutes, and you can see that they are definitely fork tender. And there's some butter in the bottom. That's probably not totally butter. There was some milk in there, and also some of the juice of the sweet potatoes has come out of there. What I want to do now is to mash these, and to do that I'm going to pour them into an all-purpose bowl. You see it has a lot of scratches. It's because I use it for things like mashing potatoes, or in this case mashing sweet potatoes. So just pour all of those in, and if you have an implement like this, then you can mash those potatoes. If you don't have that, but you have a mixer, then you can have whipped sweet potatoes. Here we go. This will take me a little while, so I'll do that and come back with mashed sweet potatoes. And I've just finished up mashing the sweet potatoes. Don't they look great? Now at this point, one way you can finish it up is to put a grinding of black pepper over the top. And so I'm going to do that step just to kind of show you how it would look, but I think I'm also going to give you the option of making a little topping here. I'm just going to rest that over there. So just a second, and I'll have my black pepper. Got my black pepper, and the ending for this is this look. That's if you don't want to add any calories or any sweetness or anything like that. So it's a very nice dish that you can enjoy at your Easter table. You can enjoy this at Thanksgiving and Christmas as well, or any time of the year. Now what I'm going to do is move to this small bowl where I have 1 tablespoon of butter that I just got out of the refrigerator, so it's cold. And this is 1/4 cup of light brown sugar. Now I'm going to add a little bit of spice, nutmeg, just a shake of that, and cinnamon, just a shake of that. So it's not even measurable other than as a pinch. And then just take a fork and start getting these together. Now this will take a while since that butter is hard, but I'll come back to you when I get this topping finished. And here is my second suggestion for our mashed sweet potatoes. Take what you have in this bowl that has just been mashed and put them in your serving bowl. These are nice and hot because they've just been mashed. And since they are hot, it works really well to put a topping that includes butter and brown sugar and some spices like cinnamon and nutmeg. The butter won't melt, and also the brown sugar won't melt with the butter, and it's going to give it that sweet flavor that some of you like with sweet potatoes. But you don't have to go that far. If you like it just with salt and pepper and butter, that's what you have here. But if you want to just take your hand and just sprinkle along the top, then in a minute or so you'll see that the butter will melt because of the hot mashed sweet potatoes, and some of you will really love this version of the mashed sweet potatoes. Just put as much as you want. I kind of limited us by only using 1 tablespoon of butter, but I think something like that looks good. Now I'll let that sit for a minute, and then I'll show you a picture of what it looks like when it's melted a little bit. Here are mashed sweet potatoes with the topping, and you can see the little bits of brown sugar and butter are beginning to melt, and I'm going to dip right in and get some of that. I don't want it all topping, but I definitely want to get some of that topping. It really complements the flavor of sweet potatoes very well, but we'll see how this is. That has to be the best vegetable there could be fixed this way. I won't say every way that I've eaten sweet potatoes that I really love, but this is a wonderful way to fix it. And if you've never done mashed sweet potatoes, I hope you'll try it because I think you will really enjoy it. Happy Easter!